Hello, my name is Greg Leek, and I'm a product manager on the SQL Server team here at Microsoft, and I'm joined by Russell Bowden.
Thanks, Greg. I'm from Intranet in New Zealand. We've been working alongside Microsoft as a Microsoft Gold partner to help provision a data insights immersion experience, a very interactive hands-on lab for people wanting to get to know big data.
Right, and so what we're going to do here in this module is actually go through the data insight immersion experience and show you some live demonstrations of technology in action. Specifically, the module that we're covering within the data immersion experience is processing unstructured data. And basically, this is going to show us how we use HD Insight in Azure with our Hadoop implementation to analyze and gain insight out of unstructured data up in the cloud. And so let's take a look at the scenario. In this scenario, we have web log data that we've put into Azure storage. This is lots and lots of data, many, many gigabytes worth of data. Web log data is very unstructured. It's not human readable. And the great use of HD Insight is to reduce this data down into useful information, targeted data that we're interested in within that web log, like click streams, the types of users that are coming into our account, where they're coming in from to do their online ordering on our online ordering site. And we're going to process that data right out of Azure Storage using HD Insight to do a map reduce job, reduce it down to just the data we're interested in. And then we're going to actually use some visualization tools.
Yeah, correct. So Microsoft has the great capability to be able to query information either from the Azure Storage blob using features inside Excel or Power BI, such as Power Query, and we can query the process data straight out of our Azure Storage blob, or we can look to query the Hive table. Now, a Hive table is a standard Hadoop distributed file system. It has all the processed information in it after we've run it through the map reduce process.
It's just a more structured version of the data of the reduced data.
Absolutely. Okay. So it's been through the process. We've shrunk it down. We've cleaned it, and we're just left with what we're interested in. But we can see that directly inside Excel.
Okay. So specifically in this module, let's just recap before we get right into the demonstration what we're going to show here. We're processing unstructured data, and we're going to do it through HD Insight. We're going to then use Excel and actually look at that data from Excel and load a Hive table back into SQL Server. Now, why would we then take that unstructured data in Excel and put it back into a structured store like SQL Server?
Well, if you imagine there can be multiple people running HD Insight jobs, you might have multiple Azure storage accounts within your organization, and it's pretty hard to track what's being stored where or who's using that
because it's
data
just a file in a file system.
Absolutely.
Or an Excel workbook.
It's no different, really, to keeping that information in a file on your desktop.
Right.
Using Scoop, which is an Apache Hadoop language, we can actually take that information from the Hive environment, and we can suck it, after it's been structured and formatted into our desired format, back into our SQL Server environment. Now, here it benefits from all those great features of an enterprise data environment, such as data governance,
security.
We've got robust security, we can implement user privileges, all of
full
that
SQL query capabilities, okay, and richer data analytics.
Absolutely.
Okay, so let's take a look at the demonstration then, Russell.
Sure. So, jumping into the immersion experience, we can see that we've got a summary of the information we're going to be looking at. Immersion is delivered through a Windows 8 application, so it's very user-friendly, very intuitive, and you can click your way through the points.
Okay, so these are the actual step-by-step instructions when a partner uses the immersion experience that we're going to demonstrate. We're going to actually go through them just as you would if you were using the immersion experience.
Absolutely. So we're going to be using this app. We can see the step-by-step instructions here, and the app actually resizes itself so that we can work and read the instructions all at the same time.
Okay.
So what we're going to do to begin with is just open up access to our HD Insight cluster.
Okay.
And we're doing that through the Windows Azure portal.
So this is the Azure portal going into the pre-provisioned subscription.
Yep. Correct.
And the subscription's even provisioned as part of the immersion experience, correct?
That's right.
So you don't even need to have your own Azure subscription to run these immersion experiences.
Absolutely. So the idea of immersion is to make this as accessible to as many people as we possibly can. So the entire environment is provisioned for you. You just need to show up, sit down, right, and learn about all the great features that we're showcasing inside the immersion.
Great.
So here we can see that we've just followed the first step. Mm-hmm. It's opened up our Azure management portal. Now I'm already logged in, so you might have to enter your credentials to log in.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is move over to our HD Insight cluster. And we've got one that's pre-provisioned for us, so we're going to access pod 8 DII cluster.
Okay.
And the first thing that we need to do here is come down to the dark bar at the bottom and start to manage our cluster environment.
Okay, so here is the HD Insight interface into the big data environment.
So this is a tile-based experience allowing us to interact with big data information.
Okay.
So we've already put our weblog files up into our Azure storage environment. And what we're going to do now is essentially come in and create a job that allows us to run through and process that information.
Okay, so we're creating a MapReduce Hadoop job.
Correct.
In our HD Insight cluster.
So we can quite simply come down to the Create Job tile.
Okay.
We can give it a name in here. So I'm going to call it the username that I'm logged on as.
I notice it's a jar file. So in Hadoop, is the typical language either Java or JavaScript that you create jobs in?
Yeah, so natively across anyone that's using Hadoop, JavaScript is the language that's used.
Okay.
Yeah. So we need to give it a job name and a jar file for it to be able to run. And we can see that until I've done that, it tells us that we've got missing parameters that are required.
Okay.
So I'm just going to jump over to the location where my jar file is stored.
And then when users are running the immersion experience, of course, they can look into the actual jar file and see all the JavaScript commands that are being run for this MapReduce job.
Absolutely.
We're not going to dive into the actual script here. We're just going to load up the prepackaged jar file.
So here's my compiled jar file.
Okay.
And the jar file essentially contains all those instructions as to how we want to group data, what we know the delimiters in the text file to be, and how we want to analyze it.
It's the actual script that runs the job to get to just the data that we want to look at out of the entire data set of the web logs.
Correct.
Okay.
So the only components that we're left to have to configure now are to set up a few parameters. And this essentially tells us what do we want to do? Where are we going to store the information? How are we going to process it? So this is parameter 0 in this case. I'm just going to paste information in from the right-hand side. So this is a set of instructions.
All right, and we can just add another one.
I can add another parameter.
And grab that over from our
grab this one.
Workbook.
Now this one is essentially telling the job where it's going to be reading data from.
Yeah, I can see there that it's referencing the blob store on Windows Azure. So we're going to take the results of this job. The source data is also in Windows Azure storage.
Yes.
But we're also going to take the results and put them in Windows Azure storage.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So the last parameter, parameter 2, is giving the path back to our storage blob.
Okay.
But we've changed the name on the end, so you can see that the input name is the weblog text file that we loaded.
And the output name
and
is the
output,
process weblog.
We're calling it process weblog. Yeah. So when we've got all of this information together, we can come in and quite simply execute this job.
So just by hitting that, it's actually going to run across the cluster and execute the whole MapReduce job.
Yep. So the first parameter is going that we put in, parameter 0,
right,
is going to go in and say, this is how I want to structure the job.
Right.
This is all the information I need to know. And then the last two parameters are your read and your write locations.
And so the job is running as we speak?
Yep, so we can see here, next to my create job tile, is the job that I've just created.
Okay, and it says in
we
progress.
We can see that it's in progress, and we might have a couple of seconds wait just while it finishes processing.
Right. So bigger jobs would probably take longer. While that's running, tell me a little bit about how many nodes you can have in your HD Insight cluster.
Absolutely. So for the purposes of this demo, because we're dealing with a small data set to prove the functionality, we're just using one node here.
Okay.
And you can see across, I think in this data set, we're close to 250,000 rows.
Right.
And we've done that in a matter of seconds. We can see that this is now complete.
Now, if we were processing, you know, terabytes or petabytes of information, how many nodes
we're,
can we provision?
We're going to want to scale up, so we can provision anywhere from between 1 and 32 nodes.
So 32 nodes could then be working in parallel if we had a larger data set.
Absolutely. And cool. 32 nodes is actually accessing 170 cores.
Okay.
So
wow.
It's a really
powerful every node has multiple cores within it.
Absolutely.
Very cool. Well, I can see this job did complete rather quickly. It looks like it's
yep.
done here.
So we're just going to go in and check, because the job tile will say complete mm-hmm. whether or not your process has succeeded or failed.
Okay. So we want to make sure that it completed with a success instead of complete with a failure.
Absolutely. So just by clicking on the job tile,
yep.
We can come in and we can actually see that that job has actually run
has
through
succeeded.
And succeeded for us. So, quite simply, in very few clicks, we've been able to come in with configured jar files, load up a MapReduce job, access our Azure storage blob, and process that information
to get down to a result set to strip out all the data that we're not interested in the web log and get down to just to the nuggets of information we want to actually perform analysis on.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So the next stage for us now is to showcase some of the features and functionality that's available through Office tools.
Okay.
So Excel is a great BI tool, information analysis and gathering tool. And now that we have our data processed through our HD Insight cluster, and it's in a nice structured format, we can access that either through the output file that we've put it back into our blob store,
right?
Or we can access that file through the Hive table that we've created as part of this process.
And the Hive table is just a more structured representation of that data, of the processed data?
Correct.
Okay.
And it sits in a standard Apache Hadoop structure. So
okay.
Hive is universal
to
Apache
Hadoop.
Yep. And we can read that in directly from Excel using ODBC drivers. And we'll cover that off now.
Okay. So we're going to open up Excel here.
Yep.
Now, I noticed you didn't have to move a file, or at least you haven't moved the results of the file. How is it that Excel is going to be able to look at this data if it was running in a Hadoop cluster?
Yep. So as we've moved the data into Hive,
mm-hmm.
using ODBC parameters, so this could be any program. We're choosing to use Excel in this case.
Right.
But we could be using something like an Access database, because we can configure the ODBC drivers in the back end. It's quite simply able to go away and interpret the structured file from the Hadoop distributed
okay.
storage network.
Great.
And we can pull that back into the analysis tool.
Okay.
So just moving down the list here, we're going to be using Power Pivot to do this. Power Pivot's a download for Excel.
Okay.
It's part of the Power BI stack, and it enables us to manage data models in tabular or in-memory format.
All right. Let's take a look at what we've got. So we're loading up a Power Pivot data model now?
So the extension of this will be to build a data model off the back end of it. At this point, we're just going to see that we can access our Hive table.
Okay.
So we're going to come to external data. We're going to say from other sources. And because we're accessing Hive, we need to choose the ODBC drivers.
Okay.
Okay. And we're going to build the connection string to go away and point to our
Hive table that we've created.
Yep. So we're just going to come over to the provider and change it to be ODBC drivers. We click the next button. We can give it the data source name. Now, for Immersion, we've taken all the coding work out of the back end for you, and we've simply created a SQL Hive data source name.
Okay.
So this is pointing to our Hive environment that we've provisioned.
So you don't have
Azure.
To create a custom connection string.
Absolutely.
It's pre-configured. Okay.
Yep. So we can then type in our credentials to access that environment. We're going to save the password. It saves me having to keep on coming back and then doing it. And we're going to the default storage location. So we're just going to test the connection.
Okay. So this is just Excel running locally, being able to access this data immediately after the job is run.
Absolutely. For all intents and purposes, this is no different to getting Excel to go away and pull back a SQL table.
Okay.
Or to pull back an analysis.
Because it's working over ODBC, just the standard database driver in this case. Okay, what's going to be the next gotcha step that we might have as we test mm-hmm. this connection out?
So the next got
is there like a is there any other trick other than what you've showed here? If you want to do a custom provider, you could have configured a custom provider a custom connection string, I mean.
Absolutely. Okay. So we could have built that from scratch.
Right.
For the purposes of Immersion, it's an introduction for people how to become familiar with this environment. Okay, so we'll just click OK.
All right.
Wait for the table list to load.
So this is going to show us the selectable data that we can establish the feed into Excel with.
It will give us the option as, do we want to write a query against our database, or do we want to pick a list of tables from source?
Okay. So here we go.
So we're just going to say select a table from the given list. And here we have the various information that we've loaded into the Hive database.
All right.
So here's our weblog table.
Right.
But we've also loaded in some additional census information, which we're going to use for analysis and other modules.
Okay, so we have an additional data set that we want to import along with the weblog data that we've been looking at.
Absolutely. So let's take a look at this one.
Okay.
Okay, so we can hit preview and filter.
So this is just going to give us a preview to make sure that we're looking at the right data, or can we actually edit the precise fields that we want to bring
in? We could choose the number of fields that we want to bring in.
Okay.
So, for instance, we're interested in state, age, and population.
All right.
But we're not going to have anything in our analysis which uses county.
Okay, so we can get rid of the county column.
So we can actually unselect county. We can say OK, and then finish.
All right.
So this is now going to go away and import our census data. And this is taking it out of Hive.
Right.
So we've followed exactly the same process that we did for our weblogs. But we have census data as well, which has been processed through a MapReduce workflow.
To get down to just the information we want, and then structured via Hive into a tabular structure?
Yep. So the MapReduce has gone through and categorized the data according to our requirements. And it's pushed it up as a structured table into Hive for us.
Okay.
So all Excel now is doing is using an ODBC driver,
right,
going to the Hive location
to look at that tabular data source
and pull that data back down.
Okay. So the advantage of Hive here is that it will produce data in a format, the extracted map reduced data in a format that Excel can understand, being a tabular workbook model.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So if we move back to our Excel workbook now, we can actually see that within our Power Pivot model, we've actually got the table with just the three columns that we had selected.
Okay.
So this is an example of how you can use ODBC drivers, and it may be in Access. In this instance, we've used Excel,
but
any program capable of using
ODBC,
and we've been able to load that information into our workbook.
Okay, what's the next step?
So the second way we can access information is actually by using Power Query. And through Power Query, we can connect directly to our Azure Blob Store. So we can pull information directly out of our Blob Storage.
Okay, and what's in our Azure Blob Storage is our actual MapReduce jobs generated from HD Insight.
Yes.
Or other data, but in this case, we're specifically interested in the data that we extracted via HD Insight and with our Hadoop MapReduce jobs.
Yes, so we're going to look at the information that we processed for our weblogs file.
All right. So we need to sign into our Azure portal.
At work.com. And this is a connection string that gets provisioned for you when you start the Immersion experience.
Okay.
So we'll just type in our password.
Because we want to look at what's in our Azure storage here, correct?
Yep.
And we're going to do that directly through the Windows Azure web portal.
So the important thing for us here is that we need to know the primary access key in order to be able to connect to our Blob Store.
Because every storage account is secured, and it's secured with digital certificates that require an encryption and decryption key.
Yes.
So we're going to now go in, log in, verified, authenticated to the Azure portal, and grab that encryption key for our storage account.
So that we can connect
so that Excel can do the decryption of the data that's in.
Yep.
That makes perfect sense.
So we'll come down to storage,
where
we have our Blob Store.
And look at our specific storage account
we're
interested in.
So we need our specific storage account, pod 11DII.
All right. And I see manage access keys right below.
So we can jump in here and grab the access key.
All right.
And we want the primary access key. So we'll just copy that.
Okay, to the clipboard.
Yep. And then we can head back to Excel. And we want to move to Power Query this time around.
All right.
and we're going to say, get me information from other sources. But we can see here that we've got our from Windows Azure HD Insight.
It's a menu item here.
So we can click this one. Now this is going to prompt us for a couple of items. It's going to ask us for the blob storage account we want to connect to. So
okay.
In this case it's pod 11 DII. Because we're logged into the Immersion mm-hmm. pod 11.
And this is really possible because of the integration that we have between HD Insight and the Azure storage. It's not the HD Insight Hadoop clusters aren't running in just an isolated environment. They're actually using Azure storage so that you can have very easy access to the data that's the results of your MapReduce jobs.
Yep, absolutely right.
Okay.
The difference that we'll see between the Hive example we've just shown and the output mm-hmm. is that it's not nicely tabulated.
All right.
But it's been developed through the MapReduce process
right.
so that we've got nice clear delimiters. So we have a little bit of work to do,
all right.
but the output from the MapReduce file is
available immediately available to us in Excel, and we can use Excel to do the work that we might need to do to get
yep.
the data in the format that we want.
And it's all done on import, so we're only having to configure this once.
Okay.
So every other time that we open this workbook, it remembers all the settings that we've applied.
Oh, right, okay.
So we can come into the screen here for looking through our blob store.
All right.
So these are all the different blobs that we've put in our storage account.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to choose DII data. We can see the output from
those
our
those are all
web
the files in this particular container.
Yep.
And we're only interested in the output of the MapReduce job.
Yep. So we can choose this particular one by double-clicking on binary.
Okay.
And here's all of our weblog data.
So we can kind of preview it here.
But we can see that it's nicely common
it's delimited.
Delimited.
Now. When we looked at this earlier, just as the raw format of the weblog, it was completely
yep.
unreadable, undelimited, and that's just the nature of weblog data. But the MapReduce job has put this in a format where we've got clean delimiters between the different elements in that file.
Absolutely. So let's do a quick comparison so we can actually see the difference.
Okay.
So let's jump into our web logs. We'll go to the log file,
mm-hmm.
and we'll open our web log text.
This is the original web log as an internet server would produce.
Yep. So this is what we put in the front end
right.
of our HD Insight and MapReduce process.
Yeah. And you can see right away the value of HD Insight to be able to jump into that very unstructured, unreadable data, make sense of it, extract just the data we're interested in, and put it in a delimited format.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. So now we've got a nice, clean, comma delimited format.
Mm-hmm.
And because this is inside Power Query, we also have the ability to write a filtering command when we import the data.
Okay.
So we can actually come through here and say split column by delimiter.
Okay.
We can choose comma. In this case, it's the default. And we could say okay.
And now it'll split into the various columns for the elements that we've extracted.
Yeah. If we wanted to, we could also come in here and we can actually say that we want to rename each individual column.
So instead of names like column one, column two, we can give them human readable
absolutely.
Column names.
Yep. So this one might become time of visit, for
sure.
example. Then we can simply click done.
Okay.
And we have the information imported into Excel in a nice clean structure. And if we wanted to, we could also load it directly into a Power Pivot data model.
Into a full-on data model in Excel.
Yeah. That's exactly right. So this shows you two different ways of being able to connect to your unstructured data. For example, we've shown how you can access Hive tables
mm-hmm.
once the data's been processed through HD Insight, and that's using ODBC drivers.
Right.
Or you can directly access the output from your MapReduce process through your Azure Blob Store. And that's using the primary keys to be able to log on to secure storage areas.
Right, and pull it down from there.
Yep. So those are two very good ways to manipulate data and to absorb them into your analysis. But there's another way that we can touch on now, which is looking at scoop commands.
Yeah, so I was going to ask, before we kind of explain scoop, it's another standard part of a Hadoop distribution, so hence it's part of HD Insight. Is it the data is still out there as a MapReduce job, but it's still just in blob storage. We have been able to get it into a personal workbook in Excel very easily, but what if we want to do some richer analysis or put this back into a structured store like SQL Server? Explain how we would be able to do that very easily now.
Yep. So the way Scoop works is that once we have information stored in our Hive tables, mm-hmm. Scoop is an Apache command, so it's developed alongside
it's
Hadoop.
It's a Hadoop command or Apache yep. command that works with Hadoop. Okay. Yep.
And we can configure this to read from an Azure Blob Store or mm-hmm. a distributed file storage mechanism, such as HDFS, the Hadoop distributed file store.
Okay.
And we can take the processed information and using a series of commands and web privileges, we can essentially write that straight back into our SQL database.
So now we have taken all that unstructured data, extracted what we needed out of it, structured it, and now ultimately put it into a full-on relational database store, in this case SQL Server, via the Scoop command.
Yeah. So if we want to show how simple this actually is, it can be achieved in a fairly limited number of steps. The Immersion actually takes you through this entire experience end-to-end in about 40 clicks.
Great.
So it's very simple to do, and if you run through it, it takes a matter of minutes. The advantage of the Scoop process is once it's completed, mm-hmm. That data exists inside your structured corporate environment. It can be managed, it's clean, it's a single source of the truth, and
right.
it stops people being able to overwrite it or corrupt it.
Right, it's in a true relational enterprise-grade database, SQL
yep.
server.
And Scoop commands also have the benefit of being able to be automated as well.
Okay, so you can script them out so you can refresh that data back into the database.
Yes, absolutely. So you're not having to reconfigure them each time you want to run them or have somebody there at the computer having to rerun them. They can be scheduled as tasks.
Great. Well, you've certainly shown us a lot in this module. I really appreciate it. And I thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the demonstration.
Thank you.